गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू. माय नेम इज अखिलेश गुप्ता. आई एम द असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट AIITM आर्य कॉलेज ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट मैनेजमेंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी ओमेक सिटी जयपुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर द लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक स्लाइडिंग कॉन्टैक्ट बेयरिंग. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज बेयरिंग. सो वी हैव टू नो अबाउट द व्हाट इज द बेयरिंग. A bearing is a machine element which support another moving machine element that is called journal. It permits a relative motion between the contact surface of the member while carrying the load. A little consideration will show that due to relative motion between the contact surface, a small amount of power wasted in the overcoming frictional resistance. So, the bearing is a machine element which support another moving element. The fixed element is called bearing and the moving part is called journal. After that we can classify the bearing broadly in two types: sliding contact bearing and rolling contact bearing. So I created a content in which I consider these areas: introduction, advantages, disadvantages, classification, what is the journal bearing and what is hydrodynamic lubrication. So I have already said there are two broadly classification of sliding contact and rolling contact. What is sliding contact bearing? Sliding means one part of the machine element moves or slides over other. While in the rolling contact bearing, they form a rolling pair. One part is rolling over the another fixed part. So this is called rolling bearing. Advantages. The advantages are the simple, the design and bearing housing very very simple. They occupy less radial space and more compact. They cost less. The design of shaft is very simple. They operate more silently and the good shock load capacity. They are ideally suitable for medium and high speed operation. In the slow speed operation, the bearing is called hydrostatic bearing because there must be a lubrication between the moving and sliding part. So that comes in the category of hydrostatic bearing. Some disadvantages are also there. The frictional power loss is more. They required good attention to the lubrication because lubrication is a very very important to lubricate time to time between the moving and fixed part. There are basically two types of load that of one is radial and another is axial load or thrust load. Thrust load along the axis of the shaft and the radial load comes into the radial direction. The types of bearing, there are four types of bearing. Basically we can classify it majorly two types: sliding contact bearing, the bearing classification, while on the basis of lubrication we can classify it into the four types. First, thick film lubrication, thin film lubrication, zero film and hydrostatic or externally pressurized lubrication bearing. I'll explain one by one what is thick film lubrication. The thick film lubrication bearings are those in which the working surfaces are completely separated from each other by the lubricant. Such type of bearing is also called hydrodynamic because the bearings are in the dynamic condition, and hydro means there is a fluid part between them. So that is hydro, hydrodynamic lubricated bearing. Another second number is thin film lubrication. The thin film lubrication bearing are those in which although lubricant is present, but working surfaces are partially contact with each other at least a part of time. Another name is thin film lubrication bearing is boundary lubrication bearing, because the lubrication film thickness is just situated in the metal to metal contact. So the film just created a boundary between them. Zero film lubrication. In the zero film lubrication, there is no lubrication is used. The running condition is without any lubricant. So this is called zero film lubrication, and completely metal to metal contact and much more wear and tear will take place. The next lubricated bearing is called hydrostatic bearing or externally pressurized. As it named, externally pressurized. So we pressurize the lubrication externally into the journal bearing. Hydrostatic means the there is no any moving part, as in the other journal meaning the journal is a moving part, but in the hydrostatic bearing there is no any moving part, all are stationary part, and a hydro means there is lubricant present. The hydrostatic bearing are those we can define as that the hydrostatic bearing are those which can support steady load without any relative motion between them. So there are broadly four types of lubrication bearing on the basis of lubricant present between them. Now the next, journal and sleeve bearing. The journal or sleeve bearing is also called the radial bearing, and they are also classified into the three types: full journal bearing, partial journal bearing, and fitted journal bearing. Full, partial, and fitted. I've shown these into the figure. You can see that in the full journal bearing, when the angle of contact between the journal and bearing is 360 degree, then this is the full journal bearing, means there is a 360 degree contact, metal to metal 360 degree contact, and there must be lubricant present between them. And the another is partial journal bearing, when the angle of contact of the bearing with journal is 120 degree, then the bearing is said to be partial journal bearing. This type of bearing is less friction and are mostly used in the railroad car axles. The another bearing is called fitted journal bearing. Fitted means there is no clearance. The first two, A and B, are the clearance, because the die of stationary part, bearing, and die of journal are not the same. So these are comes in the category of clearance bearing, while the third part comes in the fitted journal bearing, because the die of the stationary part and moving part are the same. So they are completely in touch with each other, and the angle of contact is 120 degree as in the partial journal bearing. So this is also called no clearance bearing or zero clearance bearing. right? After that, I'm going to explain the graph of hydrodynamic general bearing. Hydrodynamic general bearing. So first of all, I'll explain the axis and the graph line. What is Zn by P? What is mu? Thin film lubrication zone, thick film lubrication zone. What is K? What are that points P, Q, A, R, S? So, first of all, let me explain you some important facts. The coefficient of friction between the journal and bearing is a factor of three. Is a factor of three important criteria, three important variables. First, Zn by P. Number second, D by C, and the third one is L by D. What is Zn by P? Z is a viscosity index. Viscosity, how much viscous the lubricant is. And N is the rotational speed, that will be in RPM, revolution per minute. And the pressure created by the lubricant present. Pressure created by the lubricant present between them. This one is the first variable, that a coefficient of friction will depend on it. The second is D by C. What is D? D is a dia of journal, and C is a diametral clearance. Then the third variable is L by D. So this is a graph between mu and Zn by P only, not other two variables. See, you can see that we are approaching from point P to S via QAR. So the starting point, our study starting point will be P, and we are approaching to Q. As you can see that as we goes to point Q from point P, the viscosity index reduces. I mean, if viscosity index reduces, or the speed, the rotational speed also reduces, and the pressure increases, then the coefficient of friction must be decreases. Inversely relation. Inversely, or sorry, proportionality relation. As these factors are decreases and pressure will increases, the coefficient of friction will decreases. So this is a condition of thick film lubrication. Thick film lubrication. The point P has highly viscous and highly coefficient of friction, and this will be the at high speed. As we reduces the speed, the coefficient of friction reduces, and at point Q, the coefficient of friction will much more reduces, that there will be a condition arises when partially metal to metal contact arises. From point Q, partially metal to metal contact may arises. At point A, the speed will be at such point that metal to metal contact will be much more higher in the running condition. Then this is called the bearing characteristic number, Zn by P. Zn by P in the horizontal axis, we have taken Zn by P as a bearing characteristic number, but this is not bearing characteristic number. The value of K means value of Zn by P at the point of A is called bearing characteristic number, because at point A, partially metal to metal contact begin to occur. From this point, the speed will not the speed should not be reduces from point A. If such happens, then the metal to metal contact will be much more higher. and the wear and tear are greatly increased. So this is our requirement. The value of K should not be less than the value of Zn by P should not be less than the K. Okay. After that, we are going to point R from point A. Means as we increase, as we decrease the speed and as we decrease the Z, means viscosity, and barrier pressure increases, you will see that the coefficient of friction increases inversely relation. Means coefficient of friction does not mean that fully proportional or fully inversional and fully dependent on Zn by P at a particular value. There are variations and the graph will be seems like V. So further we decrease this value and increase the P, you can see that at point S the coefficient of friction again will reach at the highest point. Means the coefficient of friction will be much more higher at lesser speed. So there are three zones: thin film lubrication, partial lubrication, thin film lubrication. So the main significance of this curve is to show you that the value of Zn by P, the dependency of Zn by P and coefficient of friction, and the value of Zn by P should not be less than the K, the value of K, that is bearing characteristic number. So I covered in this PPT these contents, and hope you that you will satisfied from my presentation. If any doubt, you can query me. Okay, thank you very much. Stay happy.